Nothing is more terrifying when a singer gets their own game. I'm sure Britney's dance beat gave a lot of people nightmares. Before that, Michael Jackson had his own video game on the Sega Genesis called Moonwalker. Just goes to show, no matter who you are or what you've done in your lifetime, eventually you'll either get your own video game or your own talk show. Or both. Moonwalker's premise is to save the exact same girl a dozen times in every level, and then battle Mr. Big's Goon Squad. And for those of you who remember, Joe Pesci was Mr. Big. You learn something every day. For 16-bit graphics, it's not all bad. Michael moves and shakes his way through the five stages with some dancing aplenty. Even the bad guys join in the dancing, and hey, who knew dogs can get jiggy with Jacko? As you can imagine, the music features some of Michael's songs like Beat It and Bad and so forth. The effects even have his voice if you didn't already hear it by now. Control isn't much of a big deal, but as you get further in the game, the bad guys get more aggressive, and you'll find these little girls in some odd places like car trunks and graveyards. Yeah, that's sending a nice little message there, isn't it? My little message to all of you who haven't played Moonwalker? Try it. But you have been warned. Another one of our favorite arcade gems from the 80s has been somewhat updated for the PC in 2004. It's Ladybug. Now, if you didn't grow up in the 80s and have never played this game before, what's happening here is you're guiding this little bug through a Pac-Man-like maze, eating up little dots, hearts, and letters. The hearts, if snagged on the right color, multiply your points. The letters scattered throughout the maze can be used to spell out either extra for an additional life, and special, well, that's always varied from ports of Ladybug. Either you get a free game or go to a bonus level. Who knows in this version? Graphically, not a huge change from the original arcade sprites and playing field, but it's updated somewhat and it looks good overall. The sound appears to have been borrowed from previous ports, such as on the Coleco version, which I remember very well. The opening tune sounds a tad too much like that. The same applies to most of the sound effects in this game, with the exception of some additional effects and music that they added in. Control is rather slippery here. Believe it or not, I didn't intend to die right there. I was actually trying to make a turn. There's some slow response time here, so try to be careful going through the maze. The game will get a bit frantic after level 5 and up, so do your best to get as many extra lives as you can, or else you are royally screwed. Some may want to give this game a try, whether or not Ladybug was your thing back in the 80s. Still, devote a minute or so to this version. Couldn't hurt.